Good morning, students. Let us start today's class. We have come to the end part of this chapter, that is respiratory system in human being. After this, the syllabus becomes over. Okay, then we'll start revising. So let's start today's class here. Today we'll be learning about how inspired air is different from the expired air. Okay, then again after that we'll be learning about the effect of altitude on breathing, and then we'll discuss about the term like hypoxia and asphyxiation, and then the experiments related to respiration in human being. So let's start today's class. If you compare inspired air and expired air, what we usually find is that the expired air usually consists of more carbon dioxide than oxygen. And then again, it consists of more water vapor. Okay, then as compared to the inspired air. And if you talk about the inspired air, more oxygen it consists of. Then again, next, usually the inspired air is colder as compared to the expired air. Expired air are usually warmer. So this is how you can compare between inspired air and expired air. Now let us move on to the next topic, that is effect of altitude. So you may be knowing that as the altitude increases, the air pressure keeps on decreasing. Okay, the air becomes thinner and thinner, and at the same time the oxygen level also decreases. So that is why what happens is that the person who goes to high altitude, okay, they usually suffer from ear sickness. Okay, the symptoms of ear sickness are, first one is dizziness, then followed by unsteady vision, then again after that loss of hearing, then lack of muscular coordination, and finally even complete blackout may occur. So this is about how the altitude affects in breathing. Then next comes hypoxia and asphyxiation. Okay, hypoxia. Now see, if you are asked about the hypoxia, what you are supposed to say is that hypoxia is a deficiency of oxygen, okay, reaching the tissues. Okay, then the main cause of this hypoxia is sitting for a long time in a room which is poorly ventilated, okay, where there is less oxygen, okay, and it may also occur in high altitude because of decreased oxygen level. Then next comes the asphyxiation. Asphyxiation is actually the condition in which the blood becomes more venous, okay. The blood becomes more venous. Now, more venous means it becomes more deoxygenated, okay, with less oxygen, okay. It usually happens due to the accumulation of carbon dioxide, more carbon dioxide, and diminished oxygen supply, okay. So, the main causes of these asphyxiation usually occurs during strangulation, then again drowning. If someone drowns in the river or something like that, okay, that time he may find this kind of condition. Then again after that, if obstruction is there in the respiratory tract, then also this asphyxiation usually take place. Then next comes asphyxiation, okay, may also lead to death, okay, if the cause, okay, is not removed quickly. Then again, in order to overcome this asphyxiation, what we are supposed to do is that the victim must be provided with artificial respiration. So this is about the hypoxia and asphyxiation. Then after that, see, the experiments are there in your book. Okay, experiments related to demonstrating the presence of water vapor in the expired air. Okay, to demonstrate that water is lost during breathing. Okay, so what we are supposed to do is that we just have to stand in front of the mirror and then again exhale the air on the mirror. Then what happens is that the vapor which comes out along with the expired air, okay, get condensed over the surface of mirror. Okay, this proves that the expired air consists of water vapor, and we lose water vapor or water during expiration. Then again next, to demonstrate carbon dioxide is present in the expired air, what we are supposed to do is that here we use the lime water. Lime water is just like a water, okay, it is colorless. Okay, but as soon as it comes in contact with carbon dioxide, then what happens is that it turns milky. Okay, it turns milky. So the milky appearance. So whenever we expired air, into this lime water, then carbon dioxide get dissolved in lime water, and thereby it turns milky in appearance. Okay, so this proves that the expired air consists of carbon dioxide. Then there are other also experiments out there. You can go through, students. Okay, so I'm ending this chapter here only. Okay, so we'll be revising I think like in the coming classes. Okay, I think we'll be doing some live classes. Okay, alternate days. Right from the beginning we'll be starting. So keep doing your question answer, students. Thank you very much.